Until now, the Quran and Islam and Allah Azza wa Jal did not address the essence of the corruption in Mecca. Until now, the stage is being set between two parties, if you will. The one on the Haqq on one side and the one on the Batil on the other side. Surah Al-Takwir, which we are talking about today, is the first surah that starts pinpointing issues, pointing fingers now. Not only at the people like Abu Lahab, like Al-Walid, like Al-Akhnas bin Shuraiq, like Abu Jahl, like those top elites. Now talking about what is it that they are doing that should be condemned by Allah Azza wa Jal and by the Quran and by Islam and by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is wrong with this society? It's not only that these elites are standing up against Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but there is something essentially, something fundamentally wrong with this society. So this surah is talking about that. And believe it or not, the issue that Allah Azza wa Jal picks, the first issue to pick on, is the issue of woman. The issue of this concept about who woman is, who the female is, how to treat a woman, how to look at this other side of the gender. Now in Mecca, the corruption in Mecca was huge. Besides worshipping idols, which is the greatest corruption, إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمُ الْعَظِيمُ, Allah says, الشِّرْك is the greatest oppression ever. But Allah does not pick on a shirk yet. Specifically, in many other places in the Quran, there is lots of ayat that talk about shirk. But here, Allah does not even choose a riba, which is huge. It's a huge corruption and mischief in Mecca and in the society of humans as well. He does not choose this type of issue like al-mutaffifin, the ones who cheat the people and the one who abuse or exploit, if you will, the weakness of the people. He does not choose the slavery. There are lots of types of corruptions, but Allah picks this issue, which is a fundamental issue in any society, the issue of this discrimination, if you will, man-woman discrimination, female, the weak part, the female who has always been the subject of this mystery, if you will. People have always talked about and thought about and made all theories. And then at the end of the day, almost everybody, every system agrees that the woman is the weak part of the society. And for some reason, this weak spot in the society is always abused, is always oppressed, if you will. Someone is practicing oppression against this weak part, which is the woman. And here Allah Azza wa Jal picks the issue of the woman in the first surah to start talking about the illness of the society. And that shows this issue, how Islam really views the society and where to start. And those who erroneously and wrongly and mistakenly accuse Islam or pick on us for the issue of women, they don't understand how Islam dealt with this issue. So this ayah, this surah, in its major part, talks about this issue, and I will show how Allah Azza wa Jal puts it in this marvelous manner, in a manner that you cannot even imagine. How is it that Allah Azza wa Jal included this issue of the woman among issues that are part of a universal change, if you will? And among all of these, the poor little girl who was once upon a time buried in the deserts of Mecca will be raised and questioned and asked the question, who killed you? What is it that caused your death? By what reason people have killed you? Now imagine now, among all of these big events, the sun is deflamed, the stars are falling down, the seas are exploding, the mountains are being pushed around, and the animals, the camels they drop their babies, and the big monsters, they are cornered in one issue. And among all of these, الْمَوْؤُودَةُ سُئِلَتْ وَإِذَا الْمَوْؤُودَةُ سُئِلَتْ بِأَيِّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ. Equating, Allah Azza wa Jal equating the burying of a child girl alive, equating burying the child girl alive to those big events of the collapse of the sun, of the collapse of the star, of the movement of the mountains, of the exploding of the seas, of the downing of the animals, of the camels, of gathering all the animals together, all of these events, equating these to the event of the child being killed without a reason, a girl child. Does that make the concept or not? Does the Quran hit the issue or not? It hits the issue at the highest possible level. You can't do better than that. No matter how much you say, burying the child alive is wrong. Okay, it is wrong. But many people do wrong things. Okay, this is one of the wrong things. Burying the child alive or the girl alive is oppression. Well, oppression is practiced everywhere. It's part of the oppression. To make an issue, to say, oh, there was a child who was being buried alive, let's condemn that, let's take it to Security Council, let's make vote, let's make demonstrations, let's make protests. You can't do better than what the Quran did here. The Quran here is saying, killing this child alive, burying the child alive in Mecca, in Arabia, in Jahiliyyah, can only be equated to the collapse of the universe around you. It's the fall of the sun and the fall of the stars and the explosion of the seas and the movement of the mountains and all of these are barely equivalent to the killing of a child. So killing of a child is not acceptable by any means. It is condemned by all means. And Islam makes that worse than all of this universal collapse. That is a hit. That's a hit. That is a very strong hit. This is a very strong entrance in the struggle with ideas, if you will, in Mecca. Because now this is what Islam is about. Islam is not only coming to say, oh, Muhammad is a messenger, accept him, and that's it. That's not all. Islam is coming to make some corrections. Islam is coming to change the structures of the society. Islam is coming to change the core values upon which the societies are built. Here is a society in Mecca. A common practice is that when a woman bears a girl child, and if that child is born and girl, the Quran describes that in other places, إِذَا بُشِّرَ أَحَدُهُمْ بِالْأُنْثَى ظَلَّ وَجْهُهُ مُسْوَدًّا وَهُوَ كَظِيمٌ. Whenever a man is told that, oh, your wife just gave a birth to a child, girl child, what does he do? ظَلَّ وَجْهُهُ مُسْوَدًّا. His face turns black. Now the Arab face, the Arab color is not black. It's a little bit dark, but not. But ظَلَّ وَجْهُهُ مُسْوَدًّا turns black. وَهُوَ كَظِيمٌ, so sad. In another place, he says, and this man will be so obsessed, he doesn't know what to do. أَيُمْسِكُهُ أَيَدُسُّهُ فِي التُّرَابِ أَمْ يُمْسِكُهُ. He doesn't know what to do. Push that baby under the soil or keep him with hesitation, or keep the baby with hesitation. So that picture that the Quran says, this is how the society of Mecca was. If someone is told your wife is, she's pregnant, she's about to give a child, okay, I'm waiting. What did she have? A girl. Man, it's, what do I do with this girl? Shall I put it and throw it in the dirt? And usually they used to do, in fact, the people, there were two brands, there were three brands in Mecca. One brand are the elites, like Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, these are the elites. Those elites, they say, oh, our baby girls will be protected as our boys. So we don't care about us having girls. We would like to have boys, but if we don't have a boy, we are okay. So this is top elite. They say our babies are protected. We are not. In fact, there is a poet, one of them, he says, وَلَيْسَ مِنَّا الْوَائِدَاتِ. Among us are none who makes this wa'id. Wa'id is to bury the children alive. The other two categories, one category which is called the poor but brave, but idiots. Poor, brave and idiots, those are the ones, you give me a girl, she's gone all the way. I'm not going to take any chances, I will put her under the ground. That is the worst. There is some in the middle now. In the middle, they are a little bit poor, but they say, you know what? We're not going to bury the child alive. The girl, we will throw her out in the desert. She will always live and grow with the animals, with the camels, with the sheep, with the cattle. She will never mix with the people. And we will never tell the people that we have a girl there. So it's almost dead, but not dead. So that is, these ones, this category, they used to be called, these are the innocent ones. Look, this is what innocence in Jahiliyyah. Innocence in Jahiliyyah, you let the girl to be isolated, not mix with the people, don't let the people know that you have a woman somewhere. And the worst of them are the ones who bury the children alive. One man comes to the Prophet ﷺ and says, Ya Rasulullah, when I was in Jahiliyyah, I have 12 daughters. All of them, I put them under the dirt. What do I do? He became a Muslim later on, and he's telling the Prophet ﷺ, what do I do now? He says, well, the best thing you can do is for each one, you have to free a slave. Free a slave for each one. Just, you cannot return those back. And Islam now resolves, Islam has come to resolve the issues. Now this man is no longer doing it because Islam condemns that. But this was a practice. A person says, he has done it 12 times. Umar radiallahu anhu, the best khalifa, the best leader the world had ever known after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most just person, the person who used to cry at night simply if he hears someone crying, some baby crying in Medina, he would be sleepless the whole night. Before Islam, part of his duty, part of what he was famous for, is that if someone doesn't have the heart to bury his child, he will ask Umar, say, oh Umar, can you do this for me? Of course I can do this. A man without any heart. And he says, when I used to bury a child, the child would be pulling my beard or grabbing my beard. So, because she knows it. And by the way, they were not burying the children when they are only 2 days old. They would wait until they are 6 or 10 years old. So the girl knows, she is conscious. So she knows where she is going. So he says, she would be pulling my beard. And I am pushing her and she is pulling the beard. I am pushing her down and she is grabbing my beard. Until I forcefully throw her and then put the dirt on top of her. That's Umar. What did change Umar? What is it that changed Umar from the person who take the child and throw her in the well of dirt and pour the dirt upon her and the soil, to a person who would cry all night? If only he knew a child was not having enough to eat. This is the Quran. That's what changed him. Those ayat that we are reading now, when those ayat, they struck someone like Umar, إِذَا الشَّمْسُ كُوِّرَتْ وَإِذَا النُّجُومُ انْكَدَرَتْ وَإِذَا الْجِبَالُ سُيِّرَتْ وَإِذَا الْعِشَارُ عُطِّلَتْ وَإِذَا الْوُحُوشُ حُشُرَتْ وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ سُجِّرَتْ وَإِذَا النِّفُوسُ زُوِّجَتْ بِأَيِّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَ وَإِذَا الْمَوْءُودَةُ سُئِلَتْ بِأَيِّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ. That strikes him. This burying the child alive is something immense, something big, something absolutely huge that he cannot even tolerate. So that changed Umar. Those things were meant to change the core values. When people hear this and listen to this and believe in them, they know that Allah Azza wa Jal is very serious about this issue. Because sometimes, if you are careful and merciful and nice for your son or for a man or for a brother, one time, then you should be careful, more generous, more merciful, more kind for the female or gender from your family million times. That's what it says. And I want this to be heard very well among us and all of us who will hear us later on, whether on YouTube or any other place. Islam is very serious about this issue of the weak spot in the society. Islam does not want us to look at the woman or the female as the weak spot. And therefore you abuse that woman, you bury her alive, you put the soil on top of her, whether she is alive or dead. Don't do that. Don't do that. That is absolutely unacceptable. Islam came to change those core values. And sometimes it is really amazing that within our communities and societies and this so-called Muslim community, still some of us, they are very harsh when it comes to women, to females, to daughters. It doesn't mean that you don't give the proper teaching and learning and constraining, but it means that Allah Azza wa Jal, when it comes to the issue of females, is very serious from the time of the inception of the woman in the womb of her mother until she is born, until she grows up. And Allah Azza wa Jal picked this issue to be the first issue to address in Mecca. As I mentioned, in Mecca, if you look at the corruptions and the falsehoods in Mecca, they are numerous. They are absolutely numerous. There is the financial corruption, there is the political oppression, there is the slavery, there is the cheating, there is the fighting, there is the warring, there is the national bonds, the blood, then all types of fallacies and wrongdoings and mischief that were happening in Mecca. One of these is the view on woman, which starts at the time a woman is born. The time she is born, in fact, when I say the time she is born, they give the story that some woman in Mecca, when it's about to give the birth to a child, she goes and she delivers the baby right at the edge of a well. So she goes somewhere with her nurse or whoever is going to deliver her baby, and the well is already digged there. So once the baby comes out, if it's a girl, so she just dumps the girl and pours the soil on top of that and walks home, goes back home as if nothing has happened. If it's a boy, she brings the boy happy, and they make all the celebrations in Mecca, and they are happy folks. Now they have a boy, and the girl is gone. So Islam looks at this issue right from the very, very beginning, from the time of the inception of the woman. So when we talk to the world around us, when we talk to the capitalist, to the so-called democrats, to the secularists, to the new civilization people, when they bring the issue of Islam and the issue of women in Islam, say, wait a second, you can't compete with Islam. When it comes to the issue of a woman, you cannot compete with Islam. There is no system in the world, no philosopher, no ideology whatsoever that had equated the oppression that is practiced against a woman from the time of her birth, equating it to the universal explosions around us, meaning that to see a woman being oppressed, especially whether it's from the time of her birth or until the time of her death, to see that, to be equate that to the explosion and to the destruction of the entire world, no one can compete with Islam on this ground.